Son of Man and drink his blood, ye have no life in you. Whosoever eateth my flesh and drinketh my blood hath eternal life, and I will raise him up at the last day. For my flesh is meat indeed, and my blood is drink indeed. He that eateth my flesh and drinketh my blood dwelleth in me, and I in him. As the living Father hath sent me, and I live by the Father. How does he live? By the Father. So he that eateth me, even he shall live, what? By me. This is that bread which came down from heaven, not of your fathers, not as your fathers did eat manna and are dead. He that eateth of this bread shall live forever. These things said he in the synagogue as he taught in Capernaum. Many, therefore, of his disciples, when they had heard this, said, "This is a hard saying. Who can hear it?" When Jesus knew in himself that his disciples murmured at it, he said unto them, "Does this offend you? What, and if ye shall see the Son of Man ascend up where he was before? It is the Spirit that quickeneth, the flesh profiteth nothing. The words that I speak unto you, they are spirit, and they are life. But there are some of you that believe not." Brothers and sisters, do you eat and drink the flesh and blood of Christ? This is spiritually speaking. This is not physical. Are you living by the bread and the wine? Because Jesus said, if you're not, you're not his. I'm going to pick it up again at 64. Where Jesus knew from the beginning who they were that believed not, and who should betray him. And he said, "Therefore said I unto you, that no man can come unto me, except it were given unto him of my Father." From that time, many of his disciples went back and walked no more with him. Then said Jesus unto the 12, "Will ye also go away?" Then Simon Peter answered him, "Lord, to whom shall we go? Thou hast the words of eternal life." Does Jesus have the words of eternal life?
Yes.
Do we follow him?
Amen.
Or are we just actors? Tantalizing God. You know what tantalizing means? Tantalizing is like teasing. It's like giving a little bit, but not the whole. Brothers and sisters, the Adventist movement is supposed to be the final act, the final scene, I should say, in this world's history. It's not about actors and people playing. You know what the definition of an actor is? A liar. A liar. If we're sold out lock, stock, and barrel, brothers and sisters, we won't buy into the false gospel. We'll live for Christ. All through this Bible, from cover to cover, you will find no excuse for sin. Period. There's no excuse for it. If you find one, I want to know where it is, because I haven't found it. What are you holding on to? What are you holding on to? You say that you can't do it? Good. It's time to start trusting the one who has, can, and will. you will let him, he will fight for that. He's more willing to do it than you are to ask him. Listen, don't be like that little bully. I can do it. I got this. Because you're going to fall flat on your face just like he did. All of us will. Jesus didn't even go there. Okay? He completely depended upon his Father. How do you think you're greater than Jesus? Let's turn to Romans 5 and 20. But where sin abounded, grace did much more abound. Do you hear it? What does Philippians 4:13 say? I know you all know it.
I can do all things.
I can do all things. Through
Christ
who strengthens. How about Philippians 4:19?
God shall supply what?
All our needs. The secret, brothers and sisters, is in the will. That's where the secret is. It's in the will. Here, in the will, it is won or lost. It's up to you. We can form new paths. Self is the problem, brothers and sisters. Turn to Romans 6:11. Romans 6:11. For in that he died unto what? Sin. Once. But in that he liveth unto God. You believe that? Will you sign up for God's army?
Amen.
And you know what that means, don't you? If you sign up for God's army, you got a brand new commander-in-chief, and he's not you. He's not you. We must learn discipline through communion with God. If you want to be a disciple of the Lord Jesus Christ, you need to learn discipline through communion with God. If you love something, you're going to spend some time with that person or with whatever it is that you love, right? You claim to love something. If you spend no time with this thing that you supposedly love, how can you really love? What is love? What is love to you, brothers and sisters? Romans 7 and 18. For I know that in me, that is in my flesh, dwelleth no good thing. For to will, you hear that? That three-letter word that's huge. It's a four-letter word. Is present with me. But how to perform that which is good, I find not. Find not. Not in and of myself, right? But in Christ, that victory is there.
Amen.
What is it in your heart that you refuse to give up, brothers and sisters? It's probably different for all of us, but it's probably something very small. But this small little thing can cost you everything. I want to read you a little something for Adventist Hall. It's chapter 61, page 380. It's just a little teeny piece, but it's huge, okay? The surrendered heart will be guided. Heading. It is not necessary to specify here how economy may be practiced in every particular. Those whose hearts are fully surrendered to God, fully surrendered to God, and who take His word as their guide, will know how to conduct themselves in all duties of life. Is that huge? They will learn of Jesus, who is meek and lowly of heart. And in cultivating the meekness of Christ, they will close the door against innumerable temptations. I want to end on Galatians 2:20. And you all know what that says. Let's end there. I am crucified with Christ. Nevertheless, I live, yet not I, but Christ liveth in me. And the life which I now live in the flesh, I live by the faith of the Son of God, who loved me and gave himself for me. I can't even claim faith. You hear that? Did you hear that?
Mm-hmm.
It's not even my faith. Brothers and sisters, when we stop thinking about my part and what about me and mine and what I want, think about how it changes relationships when you begin to think about somebody else and their needs instead of your own. How does that work out? I mean, even if you got this guy that's just a rascal, all right? He's just a rascal. But you live in such a way with a relationship with this fella that you try to please them. What happens? Yeah. Things can shift. God has all your interests at heart. All your interests at heart. But he will not play second fiddle to anything or anybody. But you will never find anybody that will love your soul like he does.
Amen.
Our closing song is 213.
Leave time.
really getting tired of people dying. I would rather we just go home.
Amen.
And we can do that when we surrender all. Dear Heavenly Father, I thank you for the opportunity today to hear your word. Lord, we love you and we know that there is things that we hold back. And I pray that each and every one of us here would search our hearts, that we would look deep into your eyes, and that you would show us these things, that they could be rooted out, so that we would be in full surrender, so that this work could be finished, so that we could prepare a people to receive their Commander-in-Chief, the Lord of Lords. Father, we love you so much. We ask you to forgive us our sins and show us exactly what they are so they can be gone. In Jesus' name, amen.
Here. A little way.